Hi friends, so DT Maharashtra finally released the admit card for MHT CET 2018 today. So now if you are going to appear for the Maharashtra Common Entrance Test, you need to download the admit card from the official website. You can see the link of the official website and all other details in the description below. Now as you know that the admit card is a very important document, it is in fact mandatory for you to download and print it and keep it ready for the examination day. You also need to carry a photo identity proof to the exam center along with the admit card. So basically you need to take the admit card printout and a photo identity proof with you on the day of the exam. Please remember that the last date for you to download the admit card is 10th May. You need to download the admit card before this date, as after that the link will be disabled and you won't be able to log in and get the hall ticket after that. Exam is on 10th May. MHT CET 2018 has been scheduled on this date by the DT Maharashtra. It will be held in offline mode and its result will be declared on or before 3rd June. So now you know there are three key dates you need to take care of. First is 10th May, which is both the last day to download the admit card as well as the date of exam. And then there is the date of result, which is 3rd June. Now I am going to show you how you are going to download this admit card. So first of all, you are going to launch your web browser on your mobile or your computer. There you will type DTE Maharashtra. Now DTE Maharashtra conducts many exams. Of this you have to download the MHT CET 2018 admit card. So you will click on the MHT CET 2018 link. When you click the MHT CET 2018 link, you will reach the official website. Now you can see that all the instructions for the exam are on this page. Keep scrolling till you reach the application form section. Here you will see two links. One is the apply online. Don't click on this because form filling is over. You need to click on the registered candidate login, right? So when you click on the registered candidate's login, you will reach the login page. Now read these instructions carefully. First, enter all the relevant details carefully. You must have a valid email ID. Only one registration is allowed. You must have a valid mobile number. Your email and SMS mode standard of communication would be standard. And you need to keep checking the email and mobile for continuous updates from DT Maharashtra. Now while filling the form, you should have uploaded the scanned photograph as per the specifications given here. Same goes for the signature and the educational details. When you are filling the form, you should have entered which subjects you are appearing for in the exam. Right? And please note that you cannot change any detail now that the admit card is available. Below this, all the details are specifically that for application form, which is not really important now, but yes, this important date section is relevant for you. As you can see that the last date for form filling is over, and from April 24, 2018 to 10th May 2018, you can download the admit card, and the exam is on 10th May. And the result will be declared on or before 3rd June. This is very important, please note it down. Now we have reached the very important section of signing in. So what you need to do here is, here you will fill the application number, right? And here you are going to fill the password. Once you have filled these, you can see the security key that is appearing here. This you will be filling in this box. Now once you have done these three things, that is fill the application number, password and security key, you will click on the submit button, right? So when you click on the submit button, you are going to reach into the candidate login page, and there you can download the admit card, right? So now we are going to discuss a few more things about the admit card. So now once the admit card appears before you on the screen, you must see that all the details on it are correct. And if there is any error or any confusion, you should contact the authorities immediately. Then you can take a print of the admit card. You can see the print button on the screen. Try to print it on a plain white sheet of paper. students often ask whether they should take a color printout or not. The thing is, there is no hard and fast rule, but we advise you to take a colored printout because it has clearer details. You will see that the admit card contains the following things: your name, your registration number, your roll number, the test center which has been assigned to you, date of exam, your signature. Once again, I repeat, you should take the admit card and a photo identity proof to the exam hall. You can bring any of these following identity proofs: voter ID card, passport, Aadhaar card with photograph, PAN card, bank passbook with photograph, recent identity card issued by a recognized school or college, identity proof issued by a people's representative on official letterhead along with photograph, identity proof issued by a gazetted officer on official letterhead along with photograph. If you fall under PWD category and you are claiming extra time during examination, then you need to bring such documents which verify this eligibility. Please note that ration card and driving license either will not be accepted as identity proof, so please don't bring them as ID proofs. Some exam day guidelines for MHT CET 2018 are: first of all, you must arrive at the center well before the exam timing. There will be security checks which you'll have to go through, so keep in mind that you should be there on time. You will not be allowed to take anything except admit card and photo identity proof inside the examination hall. You will not be allowed to appear for the exam without the admit card under any circumstances. It is an offline exam and you will get OMR sheet wherein you will have to fill in the answers. Now see, OMR sheet will have rows of questions with A, B, C, D options with bubbles, and you will have to mark the answers in those bubbles. You should be very careful while marking answers in the bubbles in an OMR sheet. You should make sure that you fill the circle completely with black ink ballpoint pen only. Any rough work that you want to do, you need to do it in the question booklet. Do not spoil the OMR sheet at all. MHT CET will be a 3-hour long offline exam. It is an annual exam that is conducted by DT Maharashtra for admission to undergraduate engineering courses across the state of Maharashtra. Paper 1 will be mathematics and paper 2 will be physics and chemistry. To qualify, you need to attempt both papers. Seats will be allotted on the basis of your performance in the Maharashtra CET exam. So guys, best of luck for your exam. If you have any queries about the exam, please feel free to comment below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe.
Learn more and better with AglaSem.com.